Welcome to this latest video from Classic and Sports Car Centre near Malton, where we typically have over 80 classic cars in stock. Now this particular very rare Riley is one we have sold before. It's a Kestrel from 1936, and for those of you who know a little bit about Riley, they were a very innovative company, and probably the most striking feature of this, apart from the very 30s streamlined styling, is the fact that it had 1,726cc, six-cylinder, twin-cam engine. Now, at a time when lots of manufacturers were still providing cars with side valve engines, this was quite a high-performance machine. In fact, reputedly, they were capable of 85 miles an hour, though I would say, these days, probably 50 to 55 is enough. The car is a beautiful example, and sadly, on its way back to us, the previous owner towed it, and it obviously achieved a speed it wouldn't normally do because it blew the sunroof out. So part of the job that we have to do as part of its preparation is to refabricate a sunroof. That used to happen actually quite often with these, and fortunately it's a simple design to remanufacture. So that'll be done. Cosmetically, there's really not much to do at all apart from one or two small touch-ups, and mechanically she's a beauty. I mean, I've just had a good run out in the car, and it's a real pleasure to drive. It's very comfortable. The driving position itself is, you kind of low in the car, and it's a comfy position. But what I think marks it out from quite a lot of cars of this era is how good the ride is. So I'm going to give it a quick road test for you, but I'm also now going to show you around some of the detail of the car. It was called a six light saloon, and as you can see, it has three windows on each side. It has a lovely streamlined design at the rear. It's an absolutely remarkable original set of seats. Door cards appear to be original too. I think only the carpets and the headlining have been replaced in its history. Years were a period of great innovation in the British car industry, and the Riley of this type was quite an advanced motor car. Remember that even in the early 1950s, some mainstream manufacturers still had side valve engines, and yet here we are with Riley in the mid-1930s with a fabulous twin overhead camshaft engine. I mean, it was an absolute gem. At the moment I'm in neutral, and you can hear that distinctive idling sound of a pre-select gearbox. When I select first with the handbrake on and release the clutch pedal, notice the engine doesn't stall like an automatic. It has a fluid flywheel, so as soon as you press on the accelerator it starts to move off. Select the next gear, depress and engage the pedal. What a lovely sound. And that's fourth gear. Now, a previous owner has thoughtfully provided a very discreetly fitted rev counter tucked away on the right-hand side of the dash. And that's very useful because obviously it's a rare car and you wouldn't want to over rev it. It's now showing, let's just get it up to 3000 RPM. And at 3,000 RPM, she's showing just under 50 miles an hour. It's an incredibly smooth and refined motor car with quite positive steering for the age. But it's the style of it that's most impressive. Very much a child of the Art Deco era. You have a manual advanced retard mechanism, like most cars of this era. So when you want more power, you might want to advance the timing a little bit. You always retard it slightly to start. Once you get used to it, these pre-selects are an absolutely superb system. And you notice it doesn't stall because it's got a fluid flywheel. As soon as you press the accelerator, away we go. Pre-select second gear. How smooth is that? It's a lovely system. And this is really quite lively for a 30s car, and smooth because of the six-cylinder engine. I'll be mindful that I'm on quite thin tyres though as I go around these corners. But it does handle really well. Very long and low and sleek. Quite a rakish car in the 1930s. Sort of belongs in an Agatha Christie novel. And you see how smooth you can do the gear changes on this system. Beautiful. What a lovely machine.
Spent each dime I could afford, like a child in wild anticipation, long to hear that all.